Did my microphone come on? I think it did.
Huh?
Well, don't put your songbook up just yet. I turn to number 735. I want to see if you know this old song. I learned it a couple of years ago, and it's quickly become one of my favorites, so I want to see if you like it too. 735. It looks very difficult, but I promise it's really not. It's not still on. Is that better? Tell nothing yet? How's that?
That's it.
Is that it?
Yeah.
I finally got it. Okay, good. All right. Well, this song goes like this. Oh, 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 heaven is in my heart. Oh, 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 heaven is in my heart. Oh, 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 heaven is in my heart. Oh, 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 heaven is in my heart. The kingdom of our God is here. Heaven is in my heart. The presence of His majesty. Heaven is in my heart. And in His presence joy abounds. Heaven is in my heart. The light of holiness surrounds. Heaven is in my heart. Oh, 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 heaven is in my heart. Oh, 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 heaven is in my heart. Oh, 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 heaven is in my heart. Oh, 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 heaven is in my heart. We are a temple for His throne. Heaven is in my heart. In Christ is our foundation stone. Heaven is in my heart. He will return to take us home. Heaven is in my heart. The Spirit and the Bride say come. Heaven is in my heart. Oh, 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 heaven is in my heart. Oh, 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 heaven is in my heart. Oh, 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 heaven is in my heart. Oh, 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 heaven is in my heart.
Isn't that a fun little song?
Well, that took me 2 weeks to get that out of my head, so I hope you're blessed for 2 weeks. All right. Well, family, tonight I have a little pen and pad that I'm going to pass around, and I apologize for it not being lines on there, but I had some back in my trailer, and I promptly let them there. So anyway, this is for our email newsletter. If you have an email address that you'd like to share with us, I'll let you fill it out, put your name and your email address, and that'll save us a nickel and hopefully give you some joy, too. Well, family, I thank you so much for allowing me to come be with you here tonight. You notice something right away is we have a new logo. And you'll notice this right here. Kind of looks like the infinity symbol. Well, in Luke chapter 10, Jesus is concluding His parable about the Good Samaritan. You remember the Samaritan? The gentleman was wounded on the side of the road. Two men passed him by. But finally, one man who happened to be a Samaritan stopped and gave aid. And so at the end of His parable, Jesus asked, so who was the man's neighbor? Well, it was easy to see. It was the Samaritan. So He tells the people, go and do likewise. Friends, we hope and pray while we have the children there at the home that we will be able to influence them, encourage them to learn about Jesus, and hopefully become His child. And in so doing, whenever they leave the home, we hope that they can go and do likewise, you see. So that's where that comes in. Go and do likewise. Well, friends, this is our opening day. We started back in March of 1954. Opened up the first doors there. We had one single cottage at the time, but it had 24 boys on one side, 24 girls on the other, and they each shared a common bathroom. Don't you know that had to be fun? We even had 6 children to a bedroom, so I'm sure those rooms are more like a jungle gym than they were a bedroom, but most of the moms cut out a full head of hair, and we always saw that on the plus. So that's a good thing. This is our office building today. And it's not our office building. This was what used to be our office building. We went through and completely remodeled it. And on the inside, there's a great area for the kids when they get home from school to come in and do their computer homework. We know our school system are just pushing our children more and more and more toward computers. So if we can help them to be literate in that area, know how to use a computer well, but also be cautious and careful when you go on the web, because there are a lot of things there you don't need to be involved in. And so that gives us opportunity to work with our children in that way. We're blessed to have a nice reading and study room and a nice library. We're seeing that many of the children coming to us these days are maybe 3, 6, 9 months, maybe even a year behind in their schoolwork. And so we're blessed to have Eastern New Mexico University there in Portales, fine four-year college, so occasionally we can have some students come out as a tutor to our children, help them to bring their grades up to speed where they need to be. So that is indeed a great honor for us. This is our newest cottage. This is the Beckham Cottage. It actually came online in January of 19. It's a beautiful home. It's a 6,500 square foot cottage. It has four bedrooms on either end. The house parents' quarters are in the center. And, well, I'll just give you a little nickel tour through here. This is the living room. And friends, I have to tell you, we took these pictures right before the kids got there. So it's probably the cleanest you're ever going to see, is what I'm trying to say. But anyway, this is their living room. This is the kitchen area, and the kids always enjoy putting something on the table if they've helped cook it. So cookies or cakes or whatever it might be, so they enjoy that. Here's one of their bedrooms. And friends, we designed these cottages long before COVID ever came along. So each bedroom has its own bathroom. So perchance, if a child does get sick, they can be quarantined to their quarters, and it doesn't have to affect the entire cottage that way. We're blessed to have a nice laundry room on either end of the hallway. We feel it very important for our kids to know how to do their laundry. Now, men in the audience, you'll be honest with me, if you're like me, I've had to wear some pink t-shirts of my own after having done some of my laundry. Maybe you've had the same experience. Well, that's just learning how to grow up. Well, here's our pavilion that's at the back side of our campus. This is a wonderful little facility, especially in the summertime. The kids can come out and enjoy a pickup ball game and shoot. That was really nice, especially it's been as hot as it has. There's also an area there. We have groups that come through occasionally that share a cookout with us, and so we can have a nice time to sit down and have some fellowship that way. Well, here is our playground that lies on the middle of our campus. In the year 2020, we started off thinking, boy, it's looking so good. We've got everything in order. Well, that wasn't until the insurance company came out. They looked at it and said, my goodness, how long has this been here? Well, just since the early 80s. And they said, oh my goodness, well, it doesn't meet the safety standards anymore. So that had to all come out. New playground equipment put in its place. And I tell you, if you've ever helped your school system buy some new playground equipment, ouch, it's a little scary. So we were able to get that done, gratefully. We even put in a nice little splash pad for the kids to enjoy in the summer. And that's been a real treat for them, especially it's been as hot as it has. Well, here's our multi-purpose building that lies in the center of our campus. This building has been around since the mid-60s, and all we have a nice gymnasium, but we've never had a scoreboard. So we're working at getting that done. We have one secured. We're just working on getting it up on the wall now. And so our kids are all excited because they're going to have their own buzzer. So they're pretty excited about that. Friends, we have a single parent ministry there at the home. We have 27 single moms and 58 of their children. On Sunday nights, this little room behind our gymnasium, we're able to bring them out, and they have a devotional that's kind of tooled to hit them just where they are and the problems that they're facing. That's been such a blessing to them. Most of them have a very limited spiritual background, and so it's nice to be able to feed them in this way. Here's our grocery room, and you folks helped us always put toilet paper and good things in there. You know, when the COVID thing came around, oh, we missed you so badly. But we're thankful for that. But we try to keep it stocked as well as we can. And on Sunday nights, we encourage our single moms to come out and have some shopping time for their family. Here's our farm and ranch buildings, and these are about a half a mile to the northwest of our campus. But I want you to meet some of our ranch hands. Very important people. Now, this is Dalai Lama, Abby Donkey, and Katie Goat. Now, friends, have you ever been around a llama very much? Well, if you did, you realize they do not like dogs. And so we don't have to worry about coyotes getting in the herd because, well, Dolly does her job well. But we have our own 4-H club there. They're called the Shooting Stars Club, and indeed, as far as I'm concerned, they are champions already. But they learn how to take care of a market pig or a market lamb, not to mention all the goats we have, nor all the rabbits. Now, friends, in 2020, in New Mexico, there were no fairs. On top of that, there was a problem going throughout the country, sweeping out the rabbit population. Well, it took all, every rabbit that we had. So we're having to start over. But as you know, rabbits multiply quickly, so we're on our way back. So we encourage our kids to come out in the summer. Be sure to feed and water, exercise your animal well twice a day. And friends, this can be a very strenuous program, as you can see here. Now then, we'd like our kids to work hard at it, you know, and when they step into the ring in the fall, well, if they've done their homework, they're going to do quite well. We want our kids to realize, you know, hard work will pay off if you'll just exert yourself a little bit. Now, to demonstrate that, in 21, we did have a fair in New Mexico. 13 of our children got their animals in the auction, brought back $30,000. This last year, 6 of our children got their animals in the auction, brought back $25,000. And so they had done very well, very proud of that. I will tell you this, we take 20% of their earnings off the top, and that helps to pay the feed bill. And also, if we've had to have a veterinarian come out, that takes care of that. But that 80% goes into a savings account for them. So whenever they leave the home, that's a nice little nest egg tucked away for them. And some of them have done quite well over the years, so we're excited for them. This is our single parent ministry. This is Hope Haven that lies in town. We actually started it in 1983. We built 2 duplexes on our main campus. Those duplexes have recently been recommissioned for another area of our work, and I'll tell you more about that in just a moment. But when we bought this 7-acre plot of land, which is right behind the Southside Church of Christ building there in town, we were hopes of building another 15 more single-parent duplexes, which would allow us to reach another 30 more single moms or dads and their children. Well, we started off in that 2015 with our very first one. We were looking at a $6 million tab, so we were thinking at least 5 to 10 years to complete this project. Well, it seemed as though the Lord had much greater plans than we did. You see, because July of 18, all 15 of these duplexes were built, paid for, and in the black. Now, friends, who did that? Well, that credit was our Lord and Savior. It was obvious to us He wanted us to move along much quicker than what we were thinking. So, I want to just stretch your mind just a little bit. You know, it has not been that long in the church where the word divorce was very uncommon. Well, unfortunately, it's become quite commonplace in our churches today. Well, now the same thing has started then with our single parents. That was a term very rarely used, but I could probably say nearly all of us here have a single parent related to our family somewhere. And so in 2021, there were 12,007,000 single parent families in our country. Now, folks, that's almost 50% of our families today in our country are single parent. And the unfortunate part is it's not getting any better. On top of that, 80% of them were women. 34% were already living below the poverty line. And in 21, 30% of them were jobless the entire year. Now, folks, you and I both know you can drive up down the street and see help wanted signs everywhere, right? Well, for the single parent, that still takes a different connotation for them. They have to be concerned about, well, who's going to keep my child while I'm away at the new job? Who's going to pay their salary? Who's going to pay my gasoline money to and from the new job? And so they have to weigh whether that new job is going to bring any more money in or just break even like they already are. So there's a lot of problems that come along with that. On top of that, they were still concerned about where's the next meal coming from. So a lot of difficulties for our single parent families. So, here's our single parents looking to their future. What happens next? Well, here are the 15 duplexes. They're finished. We even put a nice old playground up in front of that for the children to enjoy. When they go to church and come out, they can play on the playground. When they get home from school, they can come play on the playground. But I want to stop here and state something. It is so nice to have good facilities and good programs, but friends, it's not about facilities or programs. It's about the children and families that reside within those areas. That's where the heart of the matter is, you see. Because when every child, every family that comes our way, each one of them possesses a soul. And it is our greatest desire that they know about their Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So that's where our main focus is. It's nice to have all these other things, but the children and families, that's where the biggest part of our stretch, our force is looking for. forward to. When our single parents come to us, there are several things that we require of them. First of all, we want you to attend church, go to Bible class. And as I mentioned, most of them have a very limited spiritual background. And so to be required to sit in a religious service, pretty uncomfortable for a while, I'll admit. But after they do it a while, they're beginning to realize, well, these people around me here, they like me and love me. And, well, I feel accepted and welcome here. And so we're seeing many of them becoming Christians because of that good influence toward them. We want them to work on their personal growth. Take some classes that you can learn and grow spiritually. We want them to work on their parenting skills with their relationship with their family. When they come to the home, they can have two choices. First of all, we would really like to see them go back to school. Get your education. That will help you get off the welfare list and be able to provide for your own family. And also, if they do that, they can stay for 4 years as they work toward their degree. They pay no rent, no utilities. They get a food allowance from the home. If perchance they have little ones that they need to put in daycare, there's the Children, Youth, and Family Division there in Portales that has a small grant that they can apply for that will help them to put their children in daycare. So that's really available money. Also, many of them are going online school, so they need Wi-Fi. Well, we provide that also. So many good opportunities for them to succeed. If they choose just to work, they can stay for 2 years. They receive all the same benefits, but at the end of those 2 years, they have to realize it's time to move on. And so my responsibility toward my family steps up even greater. So we're working and things are changing well for our single parents. I want to just show some of the children that have come through the home recently and share some of their stories. This young man, his name, Philip Bleedy. He actually came to us in 2015, graduated in 2020. He got a very nice scholarship to play for Texas Tech football, of which he's been doing. This was him playing on the Oklahoma Sooners and Texas Tech game. I'm sorry if you were an Oklahoma fan that day. It was not very pleasant. But anyway, very proud of Philip and his advancement there. Just recently, he has signed up to play for the Indiana Hoosiers. So he's going to be moving there for next year. And he's already prepped and ready for it. He's a fine young man. He's just a little fella. He's only 6'4", 298, and still growing, I might add. But he's a wonderful Christian man. This is Jesse, and Jesse had been with us for several years. All the while, he really loved to go to the Ponderosa Christian Camp, which was up close to Albuquerque. One year when he was there, he met this young lady by the name of Misty, and it so turned out Misty was adopted through the home back in the mid-80s, and so they struck up quite a unique relationship. She encouraged him to come back and be a counselor at the camp, and he did that a couple years, did a great job. When he got home, he realized his very best friend, Demetrio, one of our single parent children, was not a member of the church, and so he visited and studied with him, and before you know it, well, Demetrio became a Christian too. Friends, we have an adoption agency at the home, started back in 1979. And over that period of years, we have helped over 300 mothers find a wonderful home for their little baby. This is a couple on our campus that I wanted you to meet. This is Rick and Lori Daniel and their three boys. They actually adopted these three boys to the home. Their oldest there is on the left. His name is Seth. He's now 28, has his own life. He's married and they're expecting their very first child, so he's pretty excited. Their middle son on the far right is named Brandon. He has a cochlear implant, so he's a special needs child, a very fine young man. So we're grateful to be of service to this couple. Their youngest son is there in the middle. His name is Trevor. He graduated a couple years ago, and just about a month ago, he got married. So they have a lot to be excited about for their family. Friend, this is Sandra Caldera. Sandra is one of our single mothers. She was able to get back into school there at Eastern, actually graduated with her master's in counseling. So she's been working with our adoption agency and been doing a great job there. She's such a dedicated, true-hearted person to the Lord, and she was really working hard in that area. She also started two other new areas of work for us, which one is called the New Mother Homes. We're being able to assist the Pregnancy Resource Center up in Clovis, New Mexico, just about 20 miles away. They had about four young ladies who were needing of housing while they were about to deliver it. So you know those two duplexes that I talked about? We're able to offer them that, and that's a good way. But Sandra does an excellent job, as I said, counseling with them. Help them realize that there are so many more other opportunities for your baby rather than abortion. So we were so thankful for her. Also, she helped start another area of our work called Young Adults. And this is meeting the needs of our children become 18 to 22. When they become 18, they age out of the cottage, so to speak. They're not allowed to stay in the cottage anymore, so they had to be moved to another area. And this helps them graduate from high school if they're still in that area alone. Also, if they're looking for maybe going toward a technical school, go take college, they can do that. And maybe even if they want to go on to a college, four-year college, we can assist them with that. But Sandra had done a wonderful job of that. Brenda has some very sad news, and I hate to share it with you, but about 3 months ago, Sandra had stayed home to watch her 15-year-old son play a JV football game that morning. She lived way down at the west end of our campus. She was driving across the street to her office. She was broadsided by a semi, and it killed her instantly. And so we really miss Sandra. She's a precious, precious lady. Her older sister, Jessica, still works with us there. She's our single parent administrator's assistant, and she does a great job. She has two little girls of her own. But anyway, we miss Sandra, and well, it's hard to replace a young lady like Sandra. This is Jamie Twofoot, and Jamie is also one of our single mothers. She was able to get back into school at New Mexico Highlands and graduated with her master's in social work. And so now she is helping take up the slack where Sandra is missing now in our adoption agency, and also helping with our young adults in that program, helping them figure out what do I do after school, where do I go from here. And so she's been really good at helping our young people pick out a vo-tech school to go to. In fact, let me just show you, this is Jesse, remember I just mentioned him? He and two other brothers were able to go to the Universal Technical Institute down in the Dallas area to learn how to be professional welders. Well, Jesse and one of the brothers started at the same time, but the two brothers are just like peanut butter and jelly, where you saw one, you saw the other. It just crushed him to think about, I'm going to graduate before my brother. So Jesse graduated in December. One of the other boys pulled out until his brother would graduate in January so he could graduate with him too. But they're all three now licensed and professional welders, so we're very proud of them. But one of the other boys that we had from last year also is going to New Mexico State University. He's learning how to do HVAC systems. So very good things for our young people to be thinking about other than traditional school to go to. Oh, there's the two brothers. They're sweet guys. Jesus and Carlos. This is Aaron Goodman. Aaron is our executive director. He's been with us now for 6 years, 2 years in this position. He's from Las Cruces, working for a little organization that you might recognize, White Sands Missile Range. In fact, he's a bona fide rocket scientist, no lie. So he's a wonderful, wonderful man. Just about a month ago, we received very shocking news about Aaron. He has stage 4 prostate cancer. And so, friends, the hits just keep coming. And on top of that, 2 weeks ago now, Wednesday morning, two of our single moms put their children, 5 children, on the school bus to go to school. On the way, there was a very bad accident. One of the little girls was shipped to Lubbock immediately. They thought she had a brain bleed, but fortunately it wasn't that, but she does have a fractured skull in 2 places. Her older brother had to have 60 stitches. One of the other boys had a very bad concussion and a very badly sprained neck. His other two brothers, fortunately, were just beaten up. I had to say fortunately, but I'm just grateful the Lord was in the middle of all this and no lives were taken. So I'm so grateful that God is directing our work there at the home. I just want to throw in some a little bit more lighthearted pictures here. I hope you'll like some of these that come through. Harold, that's your favorite thing to do is kiss a pig, right? She bit the dust. I don't know what happened, but it must have been ugly. I'm an avid kite flyer, okay? And so last March, the little school out of Dora, just about 17 miles south of Portales, invited me to come out, bring some of my kites, and give a little demonstration on how you fly a kite. Well, I thought, what would be more fun than to take some of the kids from the home? So I took out some of the kids, and we had a ball, let me tell you. It was a good day, actually. When we got back home, we invited all the kids out from the home to enjoy flying in kite with us. The 21st Street Church in Clovis, New Mexico, I was having a food giveaway. We're always looking for good opportunities to have our children involved in being able to give back. And so some of our children were able to go to that wonderful opportunity for them to learn to give to others. This is a funny picture. You know, for many of our children, this is the first time for them to ever be around an animal. And the relationship that they create with these animals is uncanny. But this is very true. We see this quite often. Here's our six boys that were involved in our 4A football team this year. This is our longest term boy at the home. His name is Abraham. This is Xavier. This is Emmanuel, Tilden, Nehemiah, and Josiah. Josiah just left us to go back home. We missed the state by one game. These boys were our front defensive line, and they did a very good job, they did. So girls showing her goat at the fair this year. I can't help but think this pig smiling at me every time I watch that pig. He's watching the cookies rise in the oven. This is Rick showing some of our boys how to do some basic welding. And then 4-H, there are a lot of other activities other than showing animals. And so he's helping the boys how to have a parliamentary procedure meeting. This is Lisa McLeod, one of our house moms. And she's showing her girls how to do some sewing. And this was their finished product. Leadership training for Christ. I don't know if you folks know anything about that. This is one of the greatest things that our kids get to participate in. There's a lot of things that they can do. One of the things is they have a little choral group that they can sing with. There's also an opportunity for them to learn how to read scripture before a group. If you've ever had to do that, it's difficult. So that's good practice for them. They have a little interpretive reading. They learn how to give a speech. There's a banner presentation that they got to show off the home's banner there that day. And this is the 29 kids that went. And so they had a wonderful time. We're looking forward to them to do good this year. So they'll be ready to go to Tucson before long. Last year when we got home, this young man is Xavier. He'd been with us for several years, all the while asking a lot of questions. Jesus, who is he? He loves me. Why should I love him? Baptism, what's that mean? And so after they got home from LTC last year, he got up one Sunday morning and asked his house dad, this is Russell McLeod, would you baptize me today? Friend, I don't know about you, but that's the cherry on top right there. And after we're seeing our children become Christians that way, it's just uncanny the peace that comes over them. Most of them have had very tumultuous children, a childhood. And so to realize something like this, that they have a Savior who loves them, that means the world to them. And so we're grateful for that. I really do believe when you train up a child in the way he should go, when they're old, they're not apart from it. I want to give you a little example of that. This young lady is Alice Baldwin. Friend, this is my second time around at the home. I worked from 79 to 86 the first time, and I took off 25 years. I worked for my father-in-law there in Portales at a little print shop. Started back in January of 12 till now. A couple of summers ago, Alice came by the home. And she was there the first time I was at the home. She was about 10 years old. She was so excited to see me because I was one of the faces that was there when she was there the first time. She said, Tom, whenever I came to the home, me and my sister, I was 10, she was 8. She said, I'd never been hugged. No one ever told me they loved me, and I got very little discipline. But she said, when I came to the home, everyone wanted to hug me. Everyone wanted to tell me they loved me. And when I needed discipline, boy, I got it. She said, thank you for that. She said, whenever I graduated, I started work for an airman and his wife up at Cannon Air Force Base in Clovis. He got transferred to go to Des Moines, Iowa. She was their nanny, and she said, they asked me to go. I went with them. I've been with them ever since. A friend, she's not a perfect little lady, but then again, none of us are perfect, right? She has two little ones that don't have a daddy. But I often think, where would this little girl have been without the home? Where would she have been? And so many of our other children that are in the same boat. But I was delighted to see that she came back to the home because that's where she learned about Jesus. And she wanted to be at the home. So I'm grateful for the home and the influence that is coming to our children. This is a couple that are very special to me. This is George and Mary Pavlock. They started at the home 25 years ago on August the 25th. They retired this past August 25th, 25 years later. Friends, they've had over 200 children come through their home. And they're one of the most influential couples that I have ever been around because they love those kids to the core. And that's a sweet thing. So that's the question, how can you help? Well, friends, go to our website right there, nmcch.org. It's a brand new website. I'll be honest with you, we've had it up a few weeks, don't have all the bugs ironed out yet, but go look around and see what you might find. You'll notice one area there that says, work for us. Friends, we have 8 cottages on our campus. Currently, 3 of them are open simply because we cannot get house parents. That breaks my heart. There are so many children out there that we could be helping. But when you don't have workers, you can't have more kids. And so we're in need of house parents. Right now we have 3 sets. We have 14 children on our main campus. We're licensed for 36, so we can have more. So please provide, ask the Lord to provide workers for the home in that way. Another way that you can help us, you notice right here, the last 2 years have not been pleasant for the church, have they? We're seeing so many congregations, just like yourself, that are having a hard time getting their people back in the pews. And when they don't come, well, they don't tend to bring anything either. So our grocery runs have taken a steep nosedive. So after 62 years, we had to lay that aside. Now we're asking for congregations, if you could please help us 2 times a year with a special contribution to help buy groceries. Friends, we started this actually last July, and it's been amazing how the Lord is working for the churches right now. So we appreciate so much what you're doing. So I just wanted to fan your flame today and say thank you for what you're doing. We appreciate you so, so very much. We also asked a little change can, and I see several of you have brought yours back tonight. Good for you. I appreciate that. Those help us buy fresh fruit and vegetables, milk, egg, and cheese, those sort of, well, those little gold nuggets, you know, you call eggs. It helps get those to you. Well, maybe you're a Facebook follower. Maybe you're a Twitter fan. I don't do much of that one for sure. Maybe you're an Instagram person. But I know one thing you do is your prayers keep coming for the home. Friends, I know God hears every prayer that you answer. And He's faithful to answer those prayers. So please keep them coming. We depend on those. And we're grateful for the part that you play. Friends, I have some little items on my table back here, some little birthday blessing calendars. These are a perpetual calendar. It's not a yearly dated thing. So every day as you turn the page, you receive a new blessing in Scripture. Those sell for $20. I have some little hats and visors. The visors sell for $25. $20, and the hats for $25. So if you'd like to have some of those, look at that. But there's a lot of other things that is free on the table. Please take a pen and a pad and some of the other brochures about the home. Maybe you like a lanyard. One of those are free also. So just look around back. There's a lot of things. If you don't see something about it, well, ask me. I'll be happy to tell you. Friend, I want you to know you're being a blessing to children and to families by what you do. And so I want to leave you this little thought tonight. The most precious jewels you'll ever have around your neck are the arms of your children or your grandchildren or your great-grandchildren. Friends, we live in a society that blesses so many beautiful children, but it absolutely breaks my heart to see so many of them being abused and neglected for one reason or another. Folks, we're a better country than that. I'd like to see us do better than that for our children. So I guess I'm on my personal campaign today. I'd love to see that stamped out there in my lifetime. I'm already 70, so I don't know how much more time the Lord's going to give me. So y'all need to hurry, is what I'm trying to say. But that's something that we can do. One other little comment. We don't take government funds there at the home. we feel like if the government can get a finger in your pie, pretty soon they're going to tell you how to cook the pie. So we're just not going that route, okay? So that's why we can still keep the name New Mexico Christian Children's Home. That's why we can take our children to church. That's why we can still have Bible studies on our campus. Those are important values to us. We're not ready to turn that loose. So I hope you learned a lot about the home tonight. If you have questions, did I answer any of your questions? Well, either did a good job or you're all asleep. I'm not sure which it is, but thanks so much for allowing me to come. And I just want you to realize God's using you in a mighty way. So tonight, friend, I know this was not a lesson that was designed to ask you to walk down the aisle, put on your Lord in baptism, right? You know that as well as I. But if that be your desire today, that you decide you want to give your life to Christ today, then good for you. We're excited already. Or maybe if there's things in your life that you're really struggling with right now, and you realize, I just need to leave that at the foot of the cross. I'm tired of wrestling with it. Then this is the day. Or maybe it's just God's blessing you in an unordinary way and you just can't keep it in any longer. You know, we don't often talk about how the Lord's blessing us in our daily life. He is so rich and abundant in His blessings toward us. We serve an amazing God. So friends, whatever your needs are today, would you please, this is your day, would you please come while together we stand and sing? Would you come?
922.